Labor's Deputy Calvin Davis has accused National of economic sabotage. It comes after a week of the opposition claiming the relationship between New Zealand and China is deteriorating because of mishandling by the coalition government. So, what does National leader Simon Bridges make of it all? He joins us this morning from Tauranga. Tēnā koe, thanks for being with us, Mr. Bridges. Economic sabotage, what do you make of that comment?
Nah, nonsense. Look, they're doing it all for themselves. And I think they're trying to whip up a patriotism when really it's their incompetence. It's Jacinda Ardern not taking ownership of Winston Peters running amok, really, that is what you've got going on here. And it's my job to point that out. I mean, Calvin Davis made some pretty remarkable comments last week. He should stop playing the petty politics and he should focus on doing his job as Minister of Tourism when he's got a tourism sector that doesn't want him in the role and saying to the Prime Minister quite openly, give us a new minister.
But don't you have to be careful with your role here? Otherwise we have a sort of a chicken and egg situation. The more noise you make about a deteriorating relationship with China, presumably the more that relationship deteriorates.
I don't know about that. I mean, I don't think we have that power. It's the government that China would look to for their answers. I'm really pointing out the obvious and the implications of what's happened. I'm hearing this morning that the government is in crisis talks to work out what to do. That's good in a way that they're taking this seriously because it is a $27 billion relationship. You lose $1 billion off this and you're talking about 8,500 jobs for New Zealanders. But I don't think it's up to us that's doing that. I think it's really too little, too late from the government. And a Prime Minister should have got up there very early on so she could manage this complicated relationship.
There's one incident in particular I wanted to ask you about. There were concerns about seafood exports from Sanford being held up at the Chinese border. You guys brought that to the media's attention. Yep. National President Peter Goodfellow is on the Sanford board.
Well, look, you know, that is what it is. I haven't talked about this with Peter. I don't know if you're necessarily right about us bringing this forward. I think there's a range of cases, economic ones with businesses where they're seeing things slowed down. The question is that because of the deterioration in the relationship or is that just something you would see anyway? I don't know for certain. But I think if you put that with a plane turnaround, if you put it with ministers and the Prime Minister not being able to get meetings, if you put it with the story in the Herald this morning about international students dropping off. You know, you do have a problem. The government has to take it seriously. I don't think they have in the past. And I think it's right that we raise this, given the importance of this relationship to our economy and to jobs.
Okay, but it's surely not this government's fault that the US and China have entered a trade war.
No, it's not. But what it is this government's fault is Winston Peters being incredibly cowboy-like about initiatives from China, the Belt and Road Initiative, saying some very cavalier things around our defence strategy and what it means in relation to China, giving a speech at Georgetown where he was very dismissive of China implicitly. And then a Huawei decision, which I don't knock because you've got to follow the law and we'll see what happens there, but where there was no maintenance of the relationship or warning about any of this. And so the Chinese, I think, are entitled to have a few views about that. All of that together has led to this deterioration in our relationship.
Hey, there's been a lot of noise over the last couple of days about the ad you released on social media, the barbecue ad. Who made that ad?
Look, an advertising agency, a very small one. I mean, I think at the end of the day, it's a bit of fun. I don't think people should take it seriously in that regard. Other than that, it has a serious message about Kiwi Build and the government's failings. And I think, you know, if you can have a bit of humour to make that strong message work, that's good.
Did you sign off on it?
Yeah, I certainly saw it before it went out.
Were there any concerns internally about a sexist message?
No, because I don't think it's about gender. It happens to be two men and one woman. Could have been two women and one men. It's not a gender message. And I think, you know, people will, if they want to, get on that bandwagon. It's a bit of light-hearted humour. It's got a serious message to it. And we want people to hear that message.
Thanks for your time this morning. We appreciate it as always.